This is my belly, guys, at 39 weeks and 3 days. For today's video, I have a video that I actually been wanting to film for a very long time. I kept putting it off and procrastinating because like I've just been so tired and like overwhelmed and so much has been going on. So I just feel like I just kept forgetting about it. My due date is technically on Tuesday. For today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys what I'm gonna be bringing to the hospital with me. I'm gonna try to like speed this through because I don't wanna make like a super long video. Let's get right into the video. So I'm gonna start with my baby's bag. And this will be her diaper bag. Just a little cute Minnie Mouse bag. I was supposed to get like a matching Minnie Mouse stroller with it, but we actually found a way better stroller. And yeah, the Minnie Mouse one wasn't really giving safety, support, you know, all that good stuff. So in front, I have this baby cologne. Call me extra, I don't really care. I love like really good smelling babies. So I don't think I'm gonna be using this in the hospital. Most likely I will not be, but I've had this in here for so long. Might as well just keep it. I have a hand sanitizer. Then in this pocket, I have a few mittens, a few bibs, and 4 pairs of socks. Then in this one over here, I have in here something that like I'm gonna do just in the hospital. So I'm bringing this for the hospital exclusively. This is like something that we like use as like in Italy, like we use it as like a good luck charm. And this goes with these, but these are just a little, this is just a pair of socks, cute little socks. And then this is this cute little vest that you put on newborn babies when they're first born, right in contact with the skin, so that it like brings good luck for like the rest of their life, if that makes sense. Yeah, I'm gonna be taking pictures of her in this. I don't have anything in here, at least to bring to the hospital. I know that like after like when I actually use this as a diaper bag to go like around and stuff, like I'm gonna actually use this, but there's nothing in here as of right now. There's big pockets. I have a few binkies. I just put them in the Ziploc bag because why not. I have her little cute coming home outfit. It's just a little cute bow, this pink bow, and this onesie. And if everything like goes as planned and I do give birth at 40 weeks, the weather for literally all of next week is like warm. So like I don't need like a coat or anything like that, like nothing too big. So yeah. Then I brought a few outfits of like backup outfits because I don't know how many days like we're gonna be staying in the hospital for. So I brought backup outfits. This bumblebee one with this matching yellow bow, and this little summer-ish outfit with this little beanie. And then I got 3 of the like white plain onesies to go on like the bottom of these, but they're all like folded, so I'm not gonna unfold them. Then I have her first teddy bear that I want to take a picture of like while we're still in the hospital. So this is gonna be her first teddy bear. This was mine. My grandma made it for me literally actually recently, but my grandma made me this from scratch, so I just figured I'd give it to her. But it's super cute and like super soft. So then I have a swaddle. It's just like a regular swaddle, and this came with the bow to go with it so I can take pictures. I also brought this like cover just in case I need it for anything, but it's just like a cover for like the car seat, if I want to like cover the car seat when we leave, or like a cover for anything in general. Last but not least, I have this blanket. Like I said, like next week, all of next week is gonna be like warm, but it's still gonna be like, you know, like on the cold-ish side. We just got into fall, so it's like that fall weather. So yeah, and I know that babies like get colder easily than us, so yeah, that is it for her little bag. I don't feel like I overpacked. I feel like I underpacked, and I feel like I would need more. But yeah, if you guys think I need anything else for her bag, let me know in the comments. I'm also going to bring my boppy pillow. I feel like I'm already going to be super uncomfortable as is in the hospital. I just feel like this would make everything more comfortable with like breastfeeding. Also, I'm debating whether I should bring my pillow for like myself or not. I do have like a small pillow that's like my favorite that I only use for my head, so I'm probably gonna bring that like last minute. I'm also gonna bring a blanket. I don't think I'm gonna be bringing this blanket. I just looked at it and it's a little dirty, so I think I'm gonna wash this and bring my fall blanket so I can match with her. But yeah, I'm gonna be bringing the other blanket so I can wash this because it's a little dirty. Moving on to my stuff. So as of for me, I packed a few things. First of all, I have this like comfortable like sleeping clothes. They don't match anything, but they're just like sleeping clothes, you know. But I just feel like I want to be comfortable. I don't know if I'm going to be staying in the gown the whole time that I'm there, but I think I will. So I don't know if I'll actually be using these, but if I can, if I get to use them, these are perfect. I also have a nursing bra. The thing with my nursing bra is like, I don't know if I'm gonna like be using the nursing bra, because I actually like tried it on, but I don't really like the way that it feels, at least for these ones. So I think I'm just gonna be using like my regular sports bras. So hopefully the sports bras work just as fine, but I'm still gonna be bringing these just in case. I have my Freedom Mom Peri bottle. I heard that like the ones at the hospital are like really like, I don't know, they're like really weird, and they don't like, they're not comfortable to use or anything like that. So I got one of these. I also packed nipple balm for my sore nips. I also have this postpartum belly band. It has three parts to it. I don't really know how to use it, but I couldn't try it out either way because I got a big old belly. So I'm going to be bringing like the guide for it. But I definitely want to use this, and I definitely feel like every mom should get one of these. Then I just have my coming home outfit. It's just a regular like simple outfit. It's just a regular t-shirt. And I have pink sweats. These are from Pretty Little Thing, and they're actually really, really comfortable, and they're pink. My whole like vibe was to match with baby, so I'm gonna be matching with her. And I also have this sweater from Pretty Little Thing, but the thing with this, the writing on here was supposed to be pink, and it's not, it's blue. I didn't like realize that I had to pick the color. But I'm probably going to be switching. I have a pink sweater, a pink backwards sweater. So I'm probably going to be using that one instead, but it's in the wash. So I have four pairs of socks. I have long socks that I don't really usually use, but I don't know, I packed them just in case. These are the non-slip fuzzy socks, and then two pairs of short socks. Then I have two pairs of boxers because they're like super comfortable. And if you don't wear boxers, I don't know what to tell you. I literally, like, before I got pregnant, this is all I used to sleep in. And, like, then I got pregnant, and, like, my belly got big. So, like, none of that worked. And then I have my beauty case, toiletries case, whatever case you want to call it. I don't know if I'm going to be using half of this stuff, but we'll see. I have these two, these are like samples that I got in like the what do you call it, like the registry, like free baby bags. And I'm mostly bringing these because of the nursing pads that are in here. And then I have two tissue little baggies. I bring tissues with me everywhere. Like, I don't know, it's like an obsession with me. Like, I bring them everywhere because you never know when you need them. I have my makeup remover wipes. Basically, my idea is to like labor at home for as like long as I can, and then possibly like do my makeup like while I'm going through contractions to like get my mind off of it, and you know, like basically stay home for a long while and then head to the hospital when I really need to. But I plan on doing like my makeup and stuff and then just bringing my makeup with me. I highly doubt that I'll be doing my makeup in the hospital. I feel like I'll just be doing my makeup like while I'm coming home from the hospital, if that makes sense. But I'm still gonna bring him, you know, just in case. Also have spray. I know that this is like super extra, but like with me, like one thing about me is everything around me needs to smell good. And like, I feel like if I don't smell good, I'm not put together, if that makes sense. I also do plan on taking a shower there. And I always use spray after the shower. So that's gonna be a must. I mentioned shower, and I'm gonna be bringing shampoo, conditioner, and body wash. Like I said, I do plan on showering there because after birth I'm gonna feel so dirty and ugh, and I just want to shower. Then I have two little pouches things, and this one just has hair ties and like bobby pins and stuff. Somebody told me, I forget who, that I would regret if I didn't bring enough hair ties because, you know, you get to lose them and stuff. So I forget who told me, but they were like, bring hair ties because you're gonna need them. This one just has like face pads for like makeup and stuff, or like when I wash my face and stuff. Then I have my favorite lotion in this little like lotion carrier thing. I have toothpaste and toothbrush. I have a deodorant. Then another hand sanitizer. These are like moisturizing wipes for like your hands and stuff. And I really like these. They used to be in my bag, but like I really, really like these because they smell so good and like they leave your hands feeling so soft. I don't know. I don't know what it is with these wipes, but like they're really good and they're my favorite. I also have a chapstick because literally everybody, even my doctor said it, everybody and their mother said, if you do not bring chapstick, you will regret it. Because I guess your lips get like super dry and your face gets super dry. So yeah, I'm avoiding all of that. But I have this like bag for like anything wet that needs to come home. Like anything at all. Like, you know, like dirty socks, underwear, or like stuff like that, you know. Last but not least, I'm bringing two combs. And the reason for this is, I guess like they like, you put them in between your hands and they're supposed to like relieve your pressure points or something like that. I heard it from a lot of people, even my doctor said it. So it's like really good to like just have these in between your hands while you're having contractions and stuff. So I'm gonna be bringing these and see how they work. So hopefully they work. Yeah, that is basically what I have in my luggage. I'm gonna be putting this 6 feet cable also, because I feel like I need a long cable. I'm gonna be bringing my charger, but I'm also gonna be bringing this because there's gonna be like a lot of people in the room. So like, I know that like a lot of people are gonna be using the chargers and stuff. So yeah, this charger is gonna go in there too. Like I mentioned, there's a few things that like I'll be putting in as like I'm heading to the hospital. One of those is my Vanity Planet mirror. I use this on a daily because I still do my makeup, but this is like the one that like turns on. It's dead now, but it's the mirror with like the LED lights. So I'm gonna be bringing this, but I'm gonna bring it like as I'm heading to the hospital. My journal is also gonna come with me. I love writing stuff down. So like, I feel like while I'm in the hospital still, I wanna write down everything that I'm going through and everything that I'm feeling. And also one thing that I'm gonna be bringing is like a snack bag. I did buy a few snacks already. I have like a few cookies, chips, and stuff like that, but I all put them in a bag and they're sitting in my pantry. So once we are ready to go, I'm gonna grab those snacks too. So that is basically it for everything that I'm gonna be bringing to the hospital with me. I'm so over being pregnant. Like, I love it and stuff, but I'm so over it. It's just like the last few days are so draining because you know that you're like about to pop, but you're not, you know? If you guys think that like I overpacked, underpacked, if there's anything that I'm missing that I will need at the hospital or anything like that, please let me know. Comment down below. I feel like I overpacked, but I feel like I underpacked, if that makes sense. That would be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, like and subscribe, and comment down below if you want to see me do anything else before I go into labor. I want to see you guys in my next video. Bye.